how to build good habits and break bad ones. I'm Devin, the dietitian with Case Specific Nutrition, and if you watched my last video with Andrew Wade, we talked all about our own bad habits and how we kind of broke those down and how they actually were serving us in the past. But today I want to show you how to break those bad habits and also build some good ones in four easy steps. So I'll start with an example I hear from my clients a lot of the time as a registered dietitian, which is they tend to have a bad habit of hitting the drive-thru on the way home from work. They're tired and it just seems like a really easy option in the moment. So step one is you need to make it invisible. Maybe you take a different route on the way home where you're not passing that Taco Bell. Step two is you need to make it unattractive. Maybe you have a better option for dinner waiting for you at home that's going to make that drive-thru just less attractive. Step three is you need to make it difficult. Maybe you leave your wallet at home. Maybe you even, like one of my clients, delete your Postmates or DoorDash app so it's just a little bit more difficult. And then step four is to make it unsatisfying. Reflect on the last time you hit the drive-thru and how you felt afterwards. Did you feel energized and happy, or did you feel kind of overstuffed and lethargic? Reflecting on those unsatisfying experiences afterward will make you less likely to engage in that habit again in the future. So I want to take those four steps and flip it on its head to talk a little bit about how to develop good habits. A lot of my clients want to make a habit of eating breakfast in the morning and find it a little bit challenging. So step one is you need to make it visible, right? So I want you to put that bowl and that spoon and that cereal box on your counter the night before so that when you come downstairs in the morning, you are not going to miss it. Step two is you need to make it attractive. If you don't like breakfast food, there's no rule that you can't have a turkey sandwich for breakfast. Have foods that you actually enjoy for breakfast and you're going to be more likely to eat it again in the future. Step three is to make it easy. If you only have 5 minutes in the morning, talk to your registered dietitian about some easy and healthy breakfasts that you can have on the go. Step four is to make it satisfying. Include a variety of flavors, textures, maybe even colors that is going to make that meal satisfying and make you want to eat it again and again in the future. So those are the four steps to breaking bad habits and building good ones. If you enjoyed this video, make sure to hit the subscribe button below for more like it.